Hey guys, I got clownfish. Check her out. I think it's a female and it's a full grown one. So we're gonna add it to my aquarium right now. A lot of you guys have been asking for the aquarium update. This is what it looks like. I have a little bit of an allergy problem, but I figured it out. I've just been feeding them a little bit too often and not enough water changes. But I just did 5 gallon water change. This is why it looks a little bit messy and cloudy, but it's gonna clear out in a little bit. I have a whole bunch of coral in there. There's on top 3 of them. And there's one right here. By the way, water change is really simple. You go to the store, get yourself 5 gallon salt water, and you wanna have your water salinity between 122 and 1.25, somewhere around there. Perfect to be 123, 124, so in case it goes too high or too low, you have this little give. And before you change your water, you wanna check it for the salinity. Grab one of this, grab a little drop of water right here, and put like 1 or 2 drops into here. 1, 2. And all you have to do is just close this thing. Obviously, it's a lot easier when you have 2 hands. Let's look inside there and see what we got here. 1.24. Hopefully you guys can see. And you wanna check your salinity before you do water change and after. Everything looks good, you're good to go, all set. Now I'm going to add fish. So we're gonna name him Emo. Like Nemo, but Emo, because he's black and white. So we're gonna set him in the water and get the temperature of the water the same. You wanna do it gradually, get the water same quality. First of all, we worry about temperature. Then we're gonna add some of that water into this water that he's in or she's in. And then after about 15-30 minutes, we're gonna put him in the tank. After a slow process of mixing water together and making it the same temperature, so you don't shock your fish and don't kill it. Also, we'll need to get bubble anemone so that the clownfish have something to live in. It's actually they prefer it because they hide in there against predators. But at the same time, the clownfish provides food for anemone. So I'm gonna get it, set it up somewhere, and hopefully they're going to love it. It's gonna be in the future videos, probably in a week or so. So definitely subscribe to my pet channel. There's gonna be a lot of cool videos coming up. By the way guys, this is a saddleback clownfish. I'm about to ready to put him in. But there you go, this is our clownfish in there. Looks like it's doing good. Swimming around, exploring, I guess. Just need an anemone really soon, because that's what they like to live in. Look at the starfish, it's moving so much. By the way, this is what else I have. It's sifting my sand really well. It actually moves so quickly. You see all those tentacles moving around. Next video I wanna upload, I'm going to keep doing water changes at least weekly, and hopefully it will get rid of all that green algae. Looks like this clownfish really likes this coral. But that's the same thing he does to anemone. It just lives inside of it and feeds on the dead tentacles and stuff. They just benefit each other. And also clownfish will feed the anemone. This is why you shouldn't buy anemone without clownfish. It will just die most likely. But yeah, he really loved that coral. Look how cute that is. I can't believe it. Wow. That shrimp is so curious about this new addition to the tank. He wouldn't leave him alone. I know it's been a while since I posted another aquarium update because I was trying to figure it out how to do it successfully. So I only had like three coils inside there for longest time. One of them was this one and couple were on top. At first they weren't doing so good because I wasn't doing enough water change, but now I figured it out what you're supposed to do with the BioCube. It's actually pretty easy. Every 2 months I change this in a sump, in the filters over there. I put one of this in, helps with the water quality and stuff. And the most important minimum you want to do on these little tanks like that is water change at least every 2 weeks minimum. If you can do it once a week, even better. And of course you gotta figure it out how much you need to feed your aquarium. If you're feeding too much, you're going to have green algae problem. And all I have to do is just start feeding them less and more often water changes till all that green algae goes away. Oh, also I had a big problem. I didn't know how to set up the light. I was using way too much light. You see this bright light? I had almost 6 hours of full lights on like this. And that's what you do not wanna have. Not too long ago, I actually figured it out how to set up the lights. So I'm gonna press it right here, 24 hours. And this is my light set up. There is a different light set up a little bit at the time. It's a scheduled. So I have blue lights come on for a couple hours, then blue and white, then only all lights only for 2 hours. But this is my timing, so if you like to do the same thing what I'm doing. For first couple hours, you see there's a bunch of white and there's blue. Camera is flickering. In real life, it doesn't flicker. It slowly turns on. If you look into the aquarium, you see there's barely any light. So if I press this button and hold it, it will turn on all the lights. You see the difference? You do not want to have too much light in your coral reef tank. That was my biggest mistake also. So if you're gonna get BioCube, make sure you figure out how to set up the light. Maybe you can use it just like mine. But again, I have lots of windows, so I'm only running like 6 hour light on this thing. And full bright light like this, only 2 hours a day. It's all automatically. Everything else, it gradually goes brighter, brighter, brighter. 2 hours of bright, and then darker, darker, darker. So that's what I do. Simple. Actually, I love it. And it's actually nowadays pretty easy. Well guys, this is the last reef tank related video on this channel. If you want to see more videos of reef tank and my pets, link in description to my new pet channel. All right, see you next time.